Let's talk about the tweet. At Ted Cruz, your Twitter handle, liked a post that was clearly porn. What happened?
Oh, look, it was, we had a staffer who accidentally hit the wrong button. And it was a screw up. I will say Twitter went crazy with it. It became trending. Mm-hmm. As soon as we found out about it, we pulled it down. And it's generated a lot of amusement. It has prompted a lot of jokes. I understand that. I saw one person joking online that if only this had happened during the presidential, Cruz might be in the White House right now.
Have you identified the staffer? You know who it is?
We have looked into it. Yes, we have identified it. We pulled it down. It was an honest mistake. It wasn't malicious. It wasn't deliberate. It was a screw-up.
Is the staffer being punished?
We have talked with the staffer. It's not going to happen again. It was a screw-up.
Can you tell me the staffer's name?
I'm not going to out the fella. I mean, we have dealt with it internally, but I'm not going to throw someone under the bus.
Can you definitively say that it wasn't you?
It was not me, and it's not going to happen again. This was a screw-up.
Do you appreciate the irony that you once defended a Texas law banning sales of sex toys?
No, actually, I mean, that's a good example, Dana, of where the media runs with things that are just totally false.
What's false about that?
So what is false about that? So I've read online, mm-hmm. You know, Cruz supports banning sex toys.
No.
That's complete
sales.
Nonsense.
I reread the brief this morning.
So?
The sale of it.
All right. I spent 5.5 years as the Solicitor General of mm-hmm. Texas. I worked for the Attorney General. The Attorney General's law job mm-hmm. is to defend the laws passed by the Texas legislature.
I get it, yep.
One of those laws was a law restricting the sale of sex toys. Mm-hmm. It was a stupid law. Listen, I am one of the most libertarian members of the Senate. I think it's idiotic, but it's an opportunity for knuckleheads in the media to claim, oh, isn't this ironic
yeah.
that Cruz wants to ban these
okay,
things?
Okay, I can't believe I'm going to say,
people ought to be able to do what they want.
I can't believe I'm going to ask you this, but so you're officially saying Ted Cruz is okay with people buying sex toys?
I am saying that consenting adults should be able to do whatever they want in their bedrooms. You know, the media and the left seem obsessed with sex. Let people do what they want.
Let's talk about tax reform. The House and Senate Republican leaders have said that they're going to unveil their plan mm-hmm. with the White House mm-hmm. later this month, and they hope to move it through committee in October. You have your own plan out. What do you hope to see in the official mm-hmm. Republican tax reform plan?
Well, as you know, today I gave a speech laying out 7 essential elements that I think are really important. I think we need to focus on growth and jobs. And a number of pieces that I think are very important. Number one, let's simplify the tax code. Let's let everyone fill out their taxes on a postcard. We spend about 9 billion hours a year wasting time with the IRS. The world would be much, much simpler if you and I and everyone else just filled out a postcard. We produced a postcard. That's one thing I'm urging. Another big thing that I'm urging is what's called immediate expensing. And what that means is that businesses, farmers, ranchers, if you spend money on a capital investment, you can immediately expense that and deduct it from what you're paying taxes on.
What do you consider a victory for the voters who put Republicans in charge?
As a practical matter, it's going to be whatever can get 50 votes in the Senate. Okay. We have a very narrow majority. And
that is very practical coming from you.
Well, and there's wide consensus. Every Republican wants tax reform. You know, we could end up with something kind of like the Bush tax cuts light. Mm-hmm. Some modest reduction in rates, a little bit of simplification, and that's it.
Would you be okay with that?
I'd vote for that. That would be an improvement from the status quo. That'd be good.
I remember following you around on the yeah. campaign trail in 2016, and you would say to conservatives, if as a voter you think what we need is more Republicans in Washington to cut a deal with Harry Reid and Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer, Donald Trump is your guy. Was there any part of you that wanted to say, I told you so, to conservatives?
Listen, in the primary, Trump was not my first choice. as you know, I tried very hard, came close, but didn't win. Trump won. He won the nomination. He won the election. He is our president. And the role I'm trying to play now is to do everything I can to encourage the president, encourage the administration to enact positive policy.
The president's having dinner tonight. Mm-hmm. with the Democratic leaders. How do you feel about that?
Oh, I think that's fine. I think it's perfectly fine. I talk to Democrats all the time.
But are you afraid he's going to keep cutting deals with Democrats?
I will say if you look at the substantive policies we've seen in the first 9 months, I think the substantive record has been quite strong. Listen, if the administration makes some compromises where they don't achieve 100% of what we want, but we see more jobs, higher wages, less regulation, less spending, less debt, those compromises are fine.